This is Linda Sherman, at Linda Sherman on Twitter, and I'm here with Mack Collier, at Mack Collier on Twitter. And thank you so much for being with us here today, Mack.
Thank you very much for having me.
Mack is an expert on business blogging and a number of other things, but today I'd like to talk to him about business blogging and some of his tips for you who are getting started or thinking about how you'd like to improve the strategy or tactics for your business blog. So could you just give us a few of your favorite tips?
Yeah, I think it starts with trying to figure out what your strategy is going to be and trying to figure out why do you want to do a blog? I mean, do you want to do a blog to increase sales, to better connect with donors, to establish thought leadership, whatever? And I think it all starts with that, trying to figure out who it is you're trying to connect with, what that strategy is going to be, and then that'll make the rest of the process a lot simpler.
And we just finished a live blog chat with you, which was great. And one of the things you were mentioning was engaging people within the company and letting them contribute. And I thought what you were saying about it, some people don't like to write, but maybe they could do something else, was interesting.
Yeah, because what happens a lot, especially in B2B settings, I think, is that companies are looking for internal subject matter experts that can contribute to their company blog. And a lot of times, especially if they're not familiar with blogging, it's tough to get them excited about blogging and to find them the motivation to do it, because a lot of times they don't like writing. So what you can do is to help maybe get around that, say, okay, if you don't like writing, would you like to go on video? Would you like to do this thing called podcasting where we can record your audio? So give them options as far as what type of content, because they don't have to write a blog post, because a lot of people don't like to write. So if that's the case with them, say, okay, well, you're saying you don't want to write. Would you be okay with going on video for a couple of minutes and just telling us who you are, what you do every day? And you may find that, yeah, they're okay with that. So if they are, that makes it much easier to get content for your blog.
And of course, you don't tell them, go home and make a video, please. You set it all up and make it real easy for them.
Well, yeah, I mean, it depends. I mean, if you tell somebody, well, would you like to create a video or would you like to be on video, it may be that they're so excited about it, say, oh, yeah, absolutely. If you'll buy me a flip, or I've got my own flip, I'll do it already. I mean, I'm already doing it. So, yeah, I think it goes back to just trying to figure out give them as many options as possible. Like I said, they may not want to write a blog post. Well, ask them if they are comfortable doing video. They may surprise you and say, yeah, I'm already doing video. I already have a flip. I'm recording my kids, etc. I'm comfortable with that. So then they say, yeah, I'll do that for work. So, you know.
Oh, that's interesting. And then they also might feel more comfortable because they could do it 20 times till they get exactly what they want. And you're letting them choose. I like that.
Yeah, it could be that they, like I said, they could be that they don't like writing because maybe they misspell a lot of words, like I do. So maybe they're like, I don't want to deal with that because I don't want people seeing the way I write, but they may be okay with seeing themselves on video because that comes more natural to them. I don't know. It's just the idea of giving them options and getting creative with how you can get more content from your employees and not just being saying that, okay, you have to create this type of content. You know, if you're doing that, because again, these are a lot of times employees, they're not excited about the idea to begin with. So if you give them multiple options, maybe you'll click on one that resonates with them and then they'll say, yeah, I can do that. So.
I'm sure with various clients, you've seen different efforts that people have gone through to try to get traffic to their blog and get engagement on their blog. Can you talk about any of those successes or any hints that we might have for getting people engaged on a business blog?
Well, I think that this is a big concern that a lot of companies have. How do I get more engagement? How do I get more comments? How do I get more hits? But my big thing is, it's not enough to simply get more traffic, more comments, engagement. You still have to figure out, okay, is this helping me reach my ultimate goal? For example, if your ultimate goal is to sell more widgets directly on your blog, you can write a post today about Lindsay Lohan going to jail and you're going to get a million hits and a million comments, but it's not going to be from anybody that's probably going to buy any widgets for you. So it's not enough to simply think of in terms, we need engagement, we need comments. You need engagement with the right people. You need engagement with your core audience that you're trying to connect with. And if you get that, then it's a win-win. But you have to, again, be mindful of making sure that you are connecting with the right people and the right audience.
And it might be interesting to think about the timing, too, in the business cycle. So, like, if you are in tourism and you were writing about fun things to do in your particular destination, the people who've chosen their hotel may have already chosen their hotel before they're looking at fun things to do, so you have to figure out what it is that they're looking for before they make a decision.
And yeah, and that goes back to the idea of you have to figure out exactly what it is that you're trying to accomplish on your blog and who it is you're trying to connect with. Is it you're trying to connect with people that don't know about your brand and you're trying to build awareness, or is it you're trying to connect with customers that have some level of awareness, you're trying to push them to the next level where they have some interest in actually buying from you. So yeah, that's a great point. You do have to consider the business buying cycle and where they are in that process.
Great. Is there anything else that you'd like to add in about business blogging?
I think one thing is just make sure that there are no set rules. I mean, try it, and if something doesn't work for you, or if you find that something does work for you and the so-called experts are saying you're not supposed to do it that way, you know what? It may be that you've stumbled on something that works for you. There is no one size fits all for anything in social media. So if you found something that worked for you, just keep with it. And a lot of this stuff is simply trial and error, just seeing what, because this is an incredibly new space. So if you kick on something that works for you, go for it.
Absolutely. People should not be afraid of changing things and trying things and fixing it and tweaking.
Yeah.
It's just electronics. I mean, is it electrons, I should say. Yes.
Yeah. And that's one of the points I made in the live blog chat, is that somebody came up with the idea of these people that are always saying, this is the way you do this. What they normally mean is, this is the way that I did it, then it worked for me, but that doesn't mean it's going to work for Linda the same way. So you have to be mindful of this when you're, and this is a big issue because companies, organizations, whatever, when they're looking to break into social media, they're looking for guidance. What are the rules? How do we do this? And they're looking for this information, and if you're telling them there's only one way to do this, normally what that means is, this is how I did it, and it may not apply to you. So you have to be mindful of that.
Great. Thank you so much, Mack. I really appreciate it.
Thank you for having me, Linda. I appreciate it.